can't believe it.
The PBL team has worms!
I knew it! Miss Cook was acting funny all week.
These are mealworms that we have named, I think. So, Joe, Bob, Jeffrey, John Cena, and Jeff.
As y'all know, Dylan mentioned Jeff. Jeff is currently eating his best friend who is dead.
We've been recently learning that they have been attacking each other, and the one we named John Cena has been apparently being attacked a lot.
Mealworms are the type of worms that turn into people.
We're writing things down and observations on the process of turning into people.
For example, they get water out of the carrots, obviously.
They want to make sure the food they eat, which is not the carrots, is this sort of flour. There's like flour and oatmeal and different types of grains in there, and they've been eating it, so you can look right there. This mealworm is eating all of this food.
So yeah, they're pretty ghosts, but my dad ate one when he lost a bet at Mario Kart.
I want to.
So, Dylan's dad, Mr. Schultz, ate a mealworm.
He wouldn't dare bring a mealworm casserole to Mbu tonight.
Would he?
Okay, I'm Mason.
And I'm Luke. Welcome to the High Tech News.
Let's shift from eating mealworms to something a little more tasty.
Yummy pies.
And just to be clear,
eating pies at 8:45 in the morning, yummy.
Today we're learning about pie and cup, and this is my favorite lesson.
So, chocolate pudding, whipped cream, and smashed up graham crackers.
There's gummy worms, Oreos with whipped cream, chocolate, and graham crackers.
I ate the whole thing. Hey, Miss Ritter, can I have a second?
I ate my whole pie in the cup. Hey, when is snack time?
It's not even 9 a.m. and I'm eating homemade pie.
Don't forget the pie!
Do you know what a sugar rush is?
We do!
Best breakfast ever.
This is better than cereal.
This should be against the law of eating breakfast.
You can have your eggs and bacon, but I have my pie.
I feel like running 2 miles after eating this sugar.
This is my favorite breakfast ever.
I'm Coco for Coco.
Hey, Mom, I have a pie accident.
This is my favorite breakfast ever, and I want to have it every day.
There's benefits for being in first grade.
Mr. Taft, why are you stealing our pudding?
Students, the pie diet should only be attempted by first graders.
Or Miss Ritter, who ate 3 pies all by herself.
Today's show is sponsored by the one and only Miss Epps.
Miss Epps is great because
Miss Epps loves her job. Miss Epps loves her family. Miss Epps loves her class. Miss Epps loves math like us. Miss Epps loves flowers. Miss Epps loves going to church. Miss Epps loves singing at church. I'm Emily.
And I'm Sienna.
See you on the next High Tech News.
What's the only way to celebrate raising $14,000 for Jump Rope for Heart?
By throwing pies at teachers, of course. And this time, students don't miss.
Thank you.
teacher took a licking but kept on ticking.
Good job, teachers, and listen.
Coach Hodges, throwing pies at teachers never gets old.
That's it for this newscast. See you next time on the High Tech News.
She won't care!
No, I'm not going to show that part.
Oh, thank you. Thank God. Oh, my gosh. Oh, why is the solar system up there?
Ooh. Thank you, Mr. Tad. I've always wanted to be on the High Tech News. So I never really thought I would, but today's a very special day, and I will say thank you.
Mr. Taft said I would get 10 hocknickles because I did something very nice, but instead I wanted to be on the High Tech Newscast because I really wanted to be on the High Tech Newscast for super long.
So thank you, Mr. Taft and Owen. And Mr. Taft, keep on doing what you love.
After CMAS all week, students need to throw a pie at a teacher.